Monday. I am here in Tulsa, Oklahoma at Primate Jiu-Jitsu with Kendall Vernon, the owner of Gaidama Spats, which are like honestly my favorite thing in the entire world. We are head-to-toe in Gaidama right now. We're gonna go over kind of the best things to do whenever you're pregnant in Jiu-Jitsu, some drills to do, and just some advice. So I'm gonna give Kendall the floor.
So first of all, we wanna make sure that everybody watching this video understands that we're not doctors and that everything that we say and do here is based on our own personal experiences. So I'm currently training through my second pregnancy. I trained all the way through my first, was at least drilling up until the day I went into labor, and I'm currently about 18 weeks pregnant with my second. So just again, disclaimer, this is, you know, our personal experiences and what we know from talking to others in our community about their experiences training during pregnancies. A couple things like right off the bat, just to know about training when you're pregnant. At first it might seem like, you know, kind of an intimidating prospect. You're growing this life in your belly, and of course you want to protect it with everything that you are immediately. It's like our biological instinct as a woman to be overprotective of this thing. My personal belief is that doesn't mean that you have to put the rest of your life on hold while you're pregnant. When I got pregnant with my first child and was looking for information about what I could do when I was pregnant, I realized that I had friends that had ridden horses up until the day they went into labor. I knew women that ran 6-minute miles when they were 30 weeks pregnant. And so I just felt confident knowing that if my body could do something before pregnancy, it could probably also do it during pregnancy. Just obviously we have to make some adjustments to stay safe. A couple things to be mindful of are definitely stay hydrated, drink more water than you think that you need. That's true for pregnancy in general, but especially when you're training and doing a lot of super active things like jiu-jitsu. Another one is be careful of who you're rolling with. So you probably don't want to come into the gym pregnant and pick out like the most spazzy, you know, white belt in your room and decide to go hard with them, you know?
So no thanks.
Just, you know, be mindful about who you're rolling with. Make sure your training partners and coaches know. Don't keep that a secret. You know, as soon as possible, let them know that you're pregnant and that you're interested in training, but you want to stay safe. Any good gym will be accommodating to that, just like with an injury. Tell your doctors that you're training jiu-jitsu, you know? They might not super...
Be honest with your doctors, oh my God.
For sure, you know? And make sure they understand what it is and what you are doing to adjust in the sport to be safe. You know, they might... A lot of people don't know what jiu-jitsu is, you know? And so they might think it's like kicking and punching and that they're going to be afraid that you're going to catch a foot to the... You know what I mean? So just let them know what it is and tell them, you know, what your plan is moving forward and during your training.
So we're going to go right into showing you two drills that are very safe to do while you're pregnant and doing jiu-jitsu, and then we're gonna show you an attack from mount. So let's get started.
In general, to play it safe when you're pregnant, a lot of the time, anything from top is pretty much gonna be safe. You know, especially if you're concerned about, you know, catching a knee or whatever, or who you're training with, it's just, you know, better to play a top game because you're just not in jeopardy as much of compromising anything with your abdomen. We'll start with like just a basic knee slice pass. So we're gonna assume that I've already gotten to a headquarters position. There's a bunch of guards that Matt could be playing that I would have to navigate to get this position. But headquarters is just a good place to start a pass from. I have a lot of options from here, and I'm in decent control of her guard if I'm doing it right. So I'm gonna be with my right foot's gonna be just to the outside of her hip over here. My left foot's gonna be about shoulder width apart from me. I'm gonna have a hand on her hip. I'm gonna be squatting low. My elbow's gonna be on the inside of her knee right here, framing to keep her from bringing her guard back in. The other hand's gonna be on the outside of this knee. And I wanna make sure I have good posture here. So I like to have my knees a little bit pinched, my chest is tall, and my butt is low. And now we're gonna start the knee slice pass. So I'm gonna take a step to the outside, and I'm gonna start cutting my knee down to the mat right here. And the most important thing about a knee cut pass is the underhook. So if Mac gets the underhook on me right here, I'm in trouble. I'm gonna get my back taken. So I'm gonna beat her to that underhook. I'm gonna swim it in, go shoulder to shoulder right here to secure the underhook. And then I'm gonna put my head on the mat to the inside of her ear, so I'm going ear to ear with her, and I'm gonna pull up on this tricep to keep the pressure on. So we're in this position. Now, a lot of times what people will do is they're gonna hang on to your foot back here with their guard. They don't wanna get their guard passed, so they're gonna hang on with dear life to this ankle. To deal with that, instead of cutting my knee through, I'm gonna point my knee backwards behind me and cut backwards, and that's gonna help me break that lock that she has on my ankle. I'm gonna point my toes while I do it. So head on the mat, pull up on the tricep. I'm gonna point my knee back, and I'm gonna baseball slide through and come up into side control. There's just no real pressure on my belly. It's relatively basic, fundamental, it's easy to do, and it's just a great drill. It's one of the most effective passes we have in jiu-jitsu. So foot to the outside of the hip, about shoulder width apart, hand on the hip, elbow on the inside of the knee, hand on the outside of the other knee, knees kind of pinched, good posture. I'm gonna step, knee cut,
Win the underhook battle, shoulder to shoulder. Head down to the mat, pull up on the tricep, point my knee backwards, cut through, and come up into side control.
Another great drill to do when you're pregnant is any kind of like top control movement drills are always good choices. We're just gonna go straight from side control into a knee on belly transition to a backspin. So we're gonna start in side control. Mac's gonna get a frame in right here. And one of the most common escapes from side control is the knee elbow escape, where Mac would frame, bridge, shrimp, and get her bottom knee in, and now she's recovered her guard. So the drill we're gonna do is knee on belly transition to beat that reaction from her. So as I feel her going to bridge into me, I'm gonna put my hands on the mat and I'm gonna hop up to a knee on belly. Now obviously this isn't a good drill to do for the person on bottom if you're pregnant, but it's perfect for the person on top. So I'm gonna go knee on belly, Mac's gonna turn into me, I'm gonna put my hands on the mat and I'm gonna windshield wipe her to the other side, which means both of my knees are gonna come to her stomach. I'm gonna point my toes, windshield wipe her to the other side, and go knee on belly over here. I'm gonna do it one more time, hands on the mat, knees together, point my toes, windshield wiper, knee on belly. Now this time, as she turns into me, I'm gonna transition to back control. So she's gonna turn, I'm gonna take a big step around her shoulders, drop my elbow in front of her hip, big back step, and then I'm gonna get a seatbelt control right here. And I'm gonna stop there because as your belly gets bigger, it gets more and more difficult to do back control drills, but we can at least get to a position where once we have that seatbelt control and we're around the back, you know, there are a bunch of different paths we can take to actually secure the back position. Side control, she's gonna get her frame in, she's gonna start to bridge, I'm gonna put my hands on the mat, knee on belly. She turns into me, I'm gonna windshield wipe her. Knee on belly the other side, knees together, windshield wiper one more time. She's gonna turn, step, shoulder down, back step, and just secure the seatbelt here. So the third thing that we're gonna go over is an attack from mount. And, you know, there are a bunch of different attacks from mount. A basic arm bar would be a perfectly good drill for someone who's pregnant. One thing that you do want to be aware of in the mount when you're pregnant is that low mount can be kind of tough on your lower abdomen. So a lot of the times we use low mount to pry the elbows up, you know, if they're doing a really good job of framing inside of our hips. So we're just going to assume for this drill that we've already gotten that far and we have her elbows up. Because if her elbows are in, you know, it's tough for me to start mounting an attack. So usually I would use the low mount to get the elbows up and then and climb back up into mount. So we're just gonna skip that part, assume we're here. So we're gonna do an arm triangle, since a lot of people are familiar with a basic arm bar already. So I'm gonna go under the head with one hand. I'm gonna use my shoulder to put a little pressure on her jaw, and I'm gonna shift my weight. The reason I shift my weight is because if I commit my arm under her head without doing so, I'm in jeopardy of getting trap and rolled over this way. She can answer the phone right here to keep my hand trapped under her head and just bridge and roll me over that way. But if my weight is shifted, notice I've slid my knee up, my right knee up a little bit behind her shoulder. My left knee is down a little bit, but it's still pinched tight against her body. And this prevents, or at least resists, the trap and roll attempt in that direction. So I'm gonna use a little bit of shoulder pressure on her jaw here. And now I have to get this elbow up for the arm triangle. So I'm gonna scoop it with my wrist first, right at the elbow, and I'm gonna start itsy bitsy spider walking in this big arch. I'm trying to get as far to the end of the lever, right at the tip of her elbow as I can. That's gonna make her able to resist the least amount and offer me the most amount of power to get this elbow up. So I'm gonna keep walking until I get it right about to her face, right about at her ear level. The hand that's under her head is gonna trap her shoulder, so I'm hooking her far shoulder here. And now, I'm gonna bring my head down where my arm is right here to block her from bringing her elbow back down. Boom, okay? Now from here, one of the biggest reasons that people fail to finish an arm triangle is because the arm under the head isn't deep enough. So, once I get to this position, I may have to adjust even more than I think I do. I'm gonna push this arm and I'm gonna really walk this hand through as deep as I can under her neck right here. Okay, I'm trying to get this hand as deep as I can through this hole. Okay, now I'm gonna keep her arm trapped with my head. I'm gonna gable grip my hands right here. And I'm gonna come back to the square mount. And I'm gonna get my head nice and low right above her shoulder right here.
I don't want my head too high. That's another reason people fail at the arm triangle is because their head is too high up on the bicep. They don't get the right pressure on the carotid artery of this side of the neck. So my head's gonna go low, and the back of my head is gonna be driving into her arm right here. And now the best place to finish the arm triangle is off to the side. So I'm gonna go knee on belly, and then I'm gonna sprawl out to the side and squeeze. One more time, a little bit faster pace. So we're gonna assume we have the elbows up already. I'm gonna go under the head, give a little jaw pressure, shift my weight, super important. Itsy bitsy spider walk around the outside of the elbow, trap the arm with my hand, trap it with my head. Reach my hand through as deep as I can. Gable grip, get my head nice and low as I come back to the regular mount. Knee on belly, windshield wiper over. Sprawl, squeeze.
All right, well, that's pretty much all we have today. Thank you, Kendall, so much. She's going to go into a little about these new maternity spats that Gaidama has, so why don't you go ahead and tell them about it.
So again, this is my second pregnancy that I'm training through. The first one, I struggled so hard to find any kind of maternity leggings that were even the slightest bit functional for jiu-jitsu. Either they wouldn't stay put, or they were the wrong material, or whatever. So I designed these maternity spats.
They're based on our original avant-garde spats, so we have the premium compression fabric, and then there's a second layer of sweat wicking paneling in the saddle area. So that's the front panel, the crotch gusset, and the glute panels. And right here where normally there would be a panel and a waistband, we got rid of that and added this super comfy maternity panel here. So you can kind of see my little 18 week belly in it right now, but there's tons of room to grow. And it stays up really well during training. It just feels super comfortable. And so I love these. I really wish I had had them during my first pregnancy. But yeah, the world's first maternity grappling spats.
Well, thanks again for being here. Why don't you tell everybody where they can follow you on Instagram?
Oh, first of all, thank you so much for doing this. This has been super fun. I've been looking forward to it for a while. Yeah, please check out Gaidama on Instagram. Our handle is gaidama.usa. Same for Facebook, and website is gaidama.com. That's G-A-I-D-A-M-A.
And I will link all of that down below in the description, but thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel for new videos on Mondays and Wednesdays, and I'll see you next time. Bye.